6 after a wet and windy day, how long before more rain could move into our state?
It starts with the community and ends with the community in mind, so that we can be able to get through this pandemic together.
Why one local city wants to make sure COVID shots for kids aren't the only focus.
The anxiety also stops people from going to the dentist.
What dentists are doing now to help lower anxiety and ease your pain.
You know, important football is in November.
Football teams looking ahead to the playoffs, and the game of the week is here. The big stories at 6, right now. Connecticut's number one local news. This is Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us right now. First up at 6, we start with some breaking news. A teacher in Hamden has been fired after allegations of sexual misconduct.
And school officials just wrapped up a press conference about what happened about 90 minutes ago. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Marcy Jones was there. She is joining us live from Hamden tonight. And Marcy, what more can you tell us?
Well, Aaron and Mark, this was a really tough one to sit through. John Taylor, the executive director of the school, was visibly upset. He said that this was news he never imagined delivering, but he definitely said that the students' well-being is going to remain a top priority here at Booker T. Washington. Now, this all unfolded, Taylor says, this past Wednesday morning when a parent contacted him saying that she had seen some communication between her son and a female teacher that was inappropriate. The mother of the boy then sent that communication via text to him. He then contacted Human Resources, the school's legal counsel, and the Hamden Police Department. The female teacher was then pulled from her classroom and placed on immediate administrative leave while the investigation continued. After that, the school contacted parents of any students who could have been involved in some way. Staff and the board were also notified. From the time the concerned parents' phone call happened, while following all the proper protocols, to the termination of the teacher, it was approximately 36 hours. Take a listen.
On Thursday, upon further examination, we decided that the teacher had indeed violated three of our school policies as listed in the employee handbook. And that notwithstanding, we made the decision to terminate the teacher's at-will employment, effective immediately.
So far, we know that this teacher has not been identified. What we do know is that she is a female and she was hired in June and she teaches language arts. Now, John Taylor also went on to say that any students or staff who needs counseling, that will be made available to them. Live in Hamden, Marcy Jones, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
Okay, Marcy, thank you very much for that. The other big